Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to add and remove backgrounds to your Word documents. So here I've just got a sample document up, and the first way that we can change the colour of the background of our document is to go up to the Design tab and along to this icon here that says Page Colour. If you click on the drop down, you've got your colour options here, and also if you click on More Colours, you've got a colour wheel where you can move this cursor around the colour wheel, choosing any colour of the rainbow. And you can also use this slider to darken and lighten that colour. The colour you've selected will appear in this square here, and you simply click OK. Now, just so that you're aware, this only applies to the document. So if you just save this out as a PDF or you would print it, it would not show up the purple. This is just for a Word document. If you want to remove this background colour, again, you go back up to Page Colour, click on the drop down and select No Colour. So that's the first way, but that only applies to a Word document. It will not print out and not save as a PDF. So if you did want to create a background that did show up when you printed it or was part of a PDF, there's a couple of different things we can do. We can add shapes and we can add images. So the first one is to go up to Insert, go to Shapes and click on the square. Click and drag out that rectangle to cover the page. It doesn't matter if you go over the top or outside the lines, it's absolutely fine. And to make sure that the words show through or the document shows through, the first thing is to send backwards, click on the drop down and select Send to Back. And that will mean it's gone behind any images, but also you need it to go behind the text. So go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and select Behind Text, and then your text will show through. Now this rectangle is merely a shape, so it can be moved all the way around your document. In addition, we can fully customize it. So if you select Shape Format, go to Format Pane, here on the bucket icon, you've got Fill and Line. Line is the outer line, which is a tiny border line, which you can increase or decrease. But for now, we'll just concentrate on the colour in the centre, which is the fill. If we click on the drop down, we've again got solid fill, and you can go down to colour and select from your colours again. But we also got a gradient fill, and this will allow you to use this gradient slider down the bottom. I'm just going to get rid of two of these markers. If you click on these markers, you can see they have an orange outline. If I want to get rid of one, I just select the remove gradient stop. And if I want to add one, just press the plus icon there. Now each of these markers can hold a colour, so you can select it, click on colour, select a colour, again select the other one, click on colour, select another colour, and then you can move these sliders and you can see how that will affect my document. That's not the only thing you can do with gradients. If you go to type, you can make it a radial, you can click on radial or rectangular. You can also go to the presets here, but they will preset as a colour. So if I click on this one, you can see it will actually choose that colour. I'm just going to go back. You can also change the direction. So if you wanted a central gradient or other, and again, you can move these sliders to affect that as well. You can also use the transparency slider to make this more or less visible, depending on what you want, but also that will only apply to this marker that's been selected. I choose this marker as well, and I can change the transparency of that colour as well. So you can really customise the background when it comes to shapes, and you can also use pictures or textures or patterns. So we can go to pattern fill. We've got a number of different patterns that you can choose from, and in addition, you can change the colour of those patterns as well. And then if you go to picture or texture fill, you can click on the texture icon here. There's lots of different textures you can choose from. So you can use this to insert a picture or texture fill, but I'm going to show you a slightly different way to do that. So if you want to remove, so let's go back to solid fill. You can see your background is still here. If you want to remove that, just select it and press delete. And now that shape will disappear. If we go to a photograph or image, click insert, go to picture, and I'm going to select a picture from file, but you can use the stock images from your Word software. So let's go to picture from file, And let's say we want to select this image here. You can select a landscape image, but you will have to crop it. So let's select a portrait image and click insert. And as you can see, it hasn't become our background. So we have to do what we did before is select it, go to picture format, go to wrap text, click on the drop down and select behind text. Now that's gone behind our text, there's a couple of things that we can do now. We can stretch out this image so that it fills the entire page. And then we can move it if we want. We've moved the other image. And then obviously the picture is quite vibrant behind the text. So we can actually turn down the transparency. So if we select it, go to picture format and go along to transparency, click on the drop down. And you can see we've got a number of different options along here. So we can actually pick a really slight transparency where you can just about see the image, but you can also see the text as well. Now, if you're trying to get rid of this background, again, select it. You'll know that it's a background because if you try and move it, you can see you can move that background and it's basically just like a picture. So all you need to do once again is select it and press delete. So there's three different ways you can add a background and delete a background from your Word document. I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.